Should probably start the video off with showing off the build quality of this thing. It's metal versus plastic. Let me bring that closer to my mic so people can understand that. Yep, metal. We've spent a pretty long time with the Lensbaby Velvet 28mm lens. That's the new lens that they're announcing today, and it's completely different from many of their other Velvet lenses. When it comes to working with, let's say, the 85 Velvet, or I think it's a 56 or 58mm Velvet lens, they're very soft, wide open, with a little bit of sharpness, and you get sort of like this magical, beautiful, surreal look. With the Velvet 28, you're getting something that sort of is like that, but it's also far different. Where I found the Velvet 28 to be very fun is with a new type of photography that I'm doing, where basically I try to create images that look like in-camera paintings. Now, that requires you to have high contrast, shoot at a very slow shutter speed, sometimes open the lens up, sometimes close the aperture down, shoot at a lower ISO than you probably normally would. And then what you do is you go like this, obviously without the lens cap on, and you start to pull, and then you fire, and then you keep pulling through. And when you fire at around 1/15th of a second or something like that, you get an image with a lot of really cool blur that looks sort of like a watercolor painting. I've been doing it a lot with any camera system that I have. Canon, Nikon, Sony, Fujifilm, everything that I have. It's just really fun, and it shows you that you can do something completely different. Back to the Lensbaby Velvet 28mm, this lens really adapts itself well to doing that kind of stuff. Let's talk about the ergonomics and the build quality and the handling on this lens. First off, you should know that it's all metal. As you can tell, this is the lens cap, and you can hear it. Even though that's a great thing, and a lot of photographers really like metal lenses, you should know that it's not weather sealed. This, the Canon 50mm RF 1.2, I know I butchered that name, the L, it's weather sealed, but it's also a far more expensive lens and made for a completely different purpose. This is not, but this is the first lens that really started to make me think that Lensbaby should really start weather sealing their lenses. Now, this is still an affordable lens, and it's a niche and novelty lens, but I think that this lens would have been so much better served in rainy weather. The reason why is because I walk around New York City a lot. Let's say you're going by Times Square or anywhere else in Manhattan. There's always a lot of bright neon lights or bright lights in general that are reflecting off of the streets. So when you take a photo, it automatically looks like a painting. But then when you embrace it with my method of doing this, the images just pop out a lot more to you. And this there's a very specific feature about this lens that really makes it great for that kind of photography. I'll get back to that in a second though. The ergonomics on this thing, there is a manual focus ring right here. It's not rubberized the same way that Canon and many others are. Instead, it's sort of grooved, and it feels nice. It's very, very smooth, almost Zeiss level of smoothness, which is great. But the other thing is that there is an aperture ring here as well too, and the aperture ring is a little zany. Open it up to f2.5, and then there's an option to open it up even beyond that, which I think is like 2.2 or 2.1 or something like that. And that's marked by the plus. And then when you close it down, it goes down to like F22, I believe. I have a pre-production copy, so my copy is given the moniker F16. The final version will be different from what I told. Now, the Lensbaby Velvet 28 is obviously a manual focus optic like all their other lenses, and there is a depth of field scale here, which is color-coded and very interesting because you can sit there and you could say, hey, I want F8, and F8 is an orange, and there are two lines that are in orange. And then if you want F16, that's in blue. So there are two lines that are in blue. You know that when you look at the zone focusing scale, you know exactly how much of the scene is going to be in focus at F16 or F8. What I had a lot of really fun doing, and thankfully there is a functioning ring filter thread here, is putting CPL, filters on this lens, because when you shoot water, you get a lot more details when you stop down a little bit. And when you shoot like anything else, let's say I'm on the high line and I'm shooting buildings, for example, you get even more details than what this lens will allow you to do. So at any aperture, beyond like f4 or 5.6, it starts to get pretty sharp, but wide open otherwise, it's just like a painting and it's very difficult to get anything else in focus. We found that it's so soft that the contrast detection on the Canon EOS R couldn't totally figure out what was in focus. The EOS R has much better manual focus capabilities and assistance, I feel, than any other system out there. Sony's, Panasonic's, in full frame, that is, at least. But with this, like, wide open, it was so soft that it couldn't really even tell that something was there. So you have to use the magnification feature. Now, I know a lot of people really don't like manual focusing because they just don't understand it. They don't know how to zone focus or something like that. And in this case, I actually sort of agree with them because it's so low contrast and it's so soft that when you look through the viewfinder or use the LCD screen, it's almost impossible to figure out if something is actually in focus or not. And I guess because it's a Lensbaby lens, you're not really supposed to worry about that, but it's something that's obviously a concern of a lot of photographers, and I mean, of even anyone that would get this lens. Image quality-wise, this is an okay lens. It will give you all of that really nice, glorious softness that will look good in certain situations, like if you're shooting cityscapes or if you're shooting landscapes, or maybe some street stuff, but I didn't really feel it was best for street stuff. You can probably do something a little bit different than I did. But maybe if you're shooting in black and white, it might be cool. What this lens is really best known for is the bokeh. It's very, very pronounced, especially wide open. You really just won't get anything else besides bokeh. Image quality-wise, the sharpness really won't even start to get there until like f4 or f5.6. And at that point, you're just like, okay, I guess I really need it. And that's probably better for like landscapes or cityscapes or, you know, anything where you're focusing out to infinity. And that's essential. But otherwise, if you really want like a sharp portrait wide open, then you're not really going to get it here. Instead, you're just going to have to open up and just embrace the softness as much as you can. The colors are very vivid. Canon's system is very vivid to begin with, especially with the EOS R, but this just brings it over the edge. The images are very vibrant and saturated. When you bring the images into Lightroom or Capture One, you'll see just how much they really punch out at you, and it'll look like a painting, which is pretty much what it's supposed to do, in my opinion. You can check out our full review of the Lensbaby Velvet 28mm lens on our website, thephoblographer.com. But if you really want my opinion, this is a pretty novelty and niche lens. If you're looking for something that can really render super soft images, even more so than like some of those old Russian vintage lenses or old Olympus or Canon lenses, then you should go for this. If you want something that has a lot more sharpness, there's probably better options on the market. Luckily, this comes in more mounts than just Canon RF. It's also available for Sony, for Canon EF, for Nikon, for Fujifilm, for basically almost any other mount you want. So check out our review on the website, thephoblographer.com. Thanks.